Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon and welcome to Keys 4 on this very, very special occasion. Sorry to interrupt your meal. We are now going to go to the point of the day which I think just about everybody looks forward to.
Do they?
Except for us,
yeah.
It's time for the speeches. And so without any further ado, I would like to introduce the father of the bride, Dr. Sagir Hammer.
Thank you very much for this introduction. I thought I had to introduce myself. My name is this, as long as you know this, who this is speaking. Thank you very much. May I first start by welcoming you, all the guests, all the friends who have come to join with us to celebrate the wedding of my daughter and Steve. Long awaited one. I also want to welcome those guests who have come from far, far distant. Far from distance, like Oldham. I believe some aeroplane has just come from Mallorca. Few guys have come here tonight. Welcome, friends, as well. It's such a wonderful occasion, and I feel very, very proud. I feel very proud to say this thing, that I am here and my wife Carol is here. We both saw our daughter grew up in front of us, right from childhood. Now she blossomed into such a beautiful girl, what she is. I'm thinking about the links now. Everybody on the occasion like this, everybody's advised what to speak, what to say, and I have been advised also for the past few months or so. especially by my daughter. She's been telling me that don't embarrass me. Also has been telling me, don't forget the names of my friends. So I've got a list. No. I brought out the list. And I've been told not to read the name of the list.
Read it.
Especially the guests, I wanted to welcome really from far, far distance. One is from down South Wales.
Leah.
Please tell me what she's like. And few special guests who have come from a remote village is. It's very difficult to find that village, and I think it's a Roman village. Is written as Ray with the W before that. Thank you very much for coming as well. I got it. Again, I say I'm really very, very proud. by the, what I was going to say, you know, the, my daughter. She has helped me all the way through, encouraged me. She kept on telling me. And I said, Seema, people can go in, sit in the chair and they can go, but not that, you'll make it, you make it, you make it. And there we are.
You do believe make it, Dad. Oh.
If I can't walk, it doesn't mean that I can't talk. So don't interrupt me. Carol has always been advising me all the way through, as long as I remember her. She said, you mean well, but your choice of your words is awful. What can I say? English is not my mother tongue. So I'm going to face it. And drama has been the weakest subject of her mind. So if I make a mistake, please forgive me. But I can tell you tonight, I'm proud that I'm not going to make any spelling mistakes. Now, the in this rapidly revolving world, how the time is changing so quickly. It appears only just like yesterday. I welcome my daughter here in the Royal Oldham World Famous Hospital. I was running around the corridor like a madman, ringing everybody. Seema has come. Seema has come. But today, we are sitting here and already giving her away. Such as, you know. And I can't understand it. This, I don't know how many, what do you think about the word giving away? Why in this, in the 21st century, the world is never changed, it is still giving away. It should be given. It's not it's an object which we give away. Seema, she's a human being. You don't give a human being away. But you know.
You also don't want to ask you for your credit card, though.
No. Hang on with that. You shocked me for that. You know.
I'm sorry.
Get your
number.
Hurry up,
you're
running out of
time. So, running over time as well. There was, however, a time when people, the girls used to be given away many, many years ago, thousands of years ago. This tradition was there. Because people never used to care for the sentiments of the daughters they used to give away. Like the two warring nations, neighboring nations, used to get married to each other to keep the peace now. Can you imagine? Just think about it. Can you imagine? In the year 2015, Barack Obama giving his daughter to Vladimir Putin. There won't be any nuclear deterrent. You know, there will be world peace. But it's happening now in this day and age. Not here, maybe some other countries happening. Excuse me, Jimmy. It's happening. And the funny thing is that the girls are still giving away to the other, to the unknown place. And on top of that, the girls carry so much jewelry as a gift. Household gift, some cases car, some cases a house. So and on top of that, the father of the groom gets lumps of money in exchange. And that's called dowry. If you must have heard the name of dowry. Thank God I live in England. Also, Andrew is very kind to me, and he's let me off dowry. But I have to tell Andrew that my dowry to Seema is Seema herself. Her character, her nature, a loving character, her love, and respect to the family. And that's what I tell. I am confident that my daughter will make your son very happy. Going back to going back to birth of Seema. They all say what was the medical term they normally say? The confinement was uneventful. Confinement was uneventful. But you should ask the mother who gives the birth. Has it been uneventful?
No. I'm no McCarthy.
She was a beautiful girl when she was born. Honestly, she was a beautiful girl. She cried spontaneously. like a woman. Without being his bottom smack. Her Apgar was 9 out of 10. Andrew?
That's okay.
Shall I describe what is Apgar?
Sounds awful.
Ambulak Scored was lovely. Lovely. And it was cut. Her connection from mom is gone.
Oh.
But she doesn't realize that there is another cord which has been cut today. That's between me and Seema. And that's not a umbilical cord. That's credit card. As Seema grew up, you know, she took her first breath in the fresh air of Cheriton, the cul-de-sac, the Cathedral Road cul-de-sac, and also a fresh air of Wales. You know, she used to breathe. Carol used to carry her on the neck and walk all the way to halfway to Rill with Bussey, a strong boy, 3.5 year old then. Halfway to Rill, and I used to join them in the cafeteria on the beach and bring them back in the car, you know. That's what I did. And she grew slowly in front of us as she left so many, many milestones. How can I forget the milestones? Sucking the thumb. How can I forget? How can I forget the mother is crying all the time?
Still does.
How can I forget the milestone driving around on the pink bike all over Wales, falling all over the place? How can I forget about how she grew up into the schooling when I left her first time in the nursery, Elk Mill Nursery. My goodness, me and Carol both dropped her in the nursery for the first time, and she cried the hell out. She would not let us go until we both started crying. And they say it's usual for the parents. No. But she learned, she so quickly learned the rhymes. She used to come back with it. She used to entertain us. How can I forget those things? My goodness, how can I? How can I forget this thing? They were happy. They were happy days. You brought us happiness. You brought pleasure to our family. We were young. We felt young. Each time back when you were running around, we felt young. And you grew up with all the girls in the school. And you met all these friends. My goodness, they're all here today. All of your friends are here. Should I make a list?
It's not big.
Kathy, Leah, and Rochelle, the gangs, they were noisy. I'm not going to mention the other name. They honestly, they were noisy. I used to call them girls are loud. Liz, Leah, and Alexi met Seema in the university. All right, how can I forget Peter Andre? How can I forget Peter Andre? Peter, how can I forget dropping her in front of the Manchester Arena, and they were going to see the Backstreet Boys. And I parked in a double yellow line, you know, with the sticker on, but they left me, you know. So, but it was lovely, you know. Then how can I forget discussing in the house body piercing and tattooing? I had to discuss about hepatitis B. Two of our girls' friends never came back to my house. And I told them what was going to happen. So you lost two friends.
Yeah.
I know them, you know.
They're on the list.
I'm coming too long.
Do what you want.
No,
I'm
coming too. No, happy days are coming.
Jolly awesome.
Happy days are coming. That's amazing. I've done that. That's well. Yeah. There's another. How can I forget when you were 5 years old? 5 years old. Carol will tell. It was some beautiful occasion, some royal occasion, when British Rail has put a special train which took from Chester to Rail to Cowan Bay to Londono and back again. So we were waiting to have a ride. And Seema wanted to go to the toilet. And she asked the permission, said, can I go, Mom, to the toilet? She said, yes, you can go. This is the next door to you. I'll watch you. Seema comes back again after 5 minutes, walking behind a tall woman who was sitting next to us. And she stood up in the middle and she said, Mom, that lady didn't wash her hands. Yes. Also, when she took Spanish, so I took her to Wales, to Spain to brush up her Spanish vocabulary. So we went there, a beautiful hotel, lovely hotel, really enjoyed it. we celebrated the 4th of July. If you think 4th of July was an American holiday, you're wrong. It was Kathy's birthday. There was a German boy called Rudiger. He took fancy towards Kathy. She was glad. She was glad when 2 weeks were over. Now, after, of course, this is the, of course, the most memorable day. But there was another very memorable day for Seema, where I and Carol both enjoyed it. When I went to Leeds, when she went to the rostrum, I took the degree of BA Honours. Oh. Seema Ahmad, BA Honours. Spanish. So when I took her to Spain, we were in walking in Alhambra Gardens, and the ground, I think it was very, very, very hot, and these few Spanish gypsy girls came to, they were selling flowers to, and the flowers very miserable looking, you know, droopy, you know, so I wasn't very keen to buy the flowers. So I said, no, thanks. So I walked with Kathy to the restaurant, and Seema wasn't coming back, and she was having an argument with that girl. So I said, what's the matter, Seema? Why, it's a bit heated argument. I said, Dad, you don't realize, she has cursed you in Spanish. I said, well, this was really Spanish, I wouldn't understand it anyway. I didn't bother about it.
Will you tell her off, Seema?
And
how much time have I got?
Don't worry, Siggy.
I'm getting warmed up. I'm going to talk about diabetes now.
No.
Cholesterol.
Let me say how. What happened was, Seema got her first job. I'm finishing up. Seema got her first job. That was a revolution, Oldham revolution. And that was the beginning of your life, I would think. I won't go any further. I could go on.
No.
But I could go on if Steve let me. When Steve came to my house first time, my goodness, he was so gentle. He was so... the first impression was absolutely wonderful. Hey, it's very, very kind. I said, come on, Steve, would you like to have a drink? Yes, sir. But don't call me, sir. So, he didn't laugh at that. Don't call me, sir. Come on, laugh. The first thing I said, Steve, I have seen your photograph in the newspaper. I said, have you? I bet it was in the crime report.
It was Gosmill lighting. No.
I said, no, your photograph was, it was Oldham Revolution's staff was, they published it. So that's what I said. So that's why I met Steve. He was, his sense of humor, I recognize right from the day one, he's got an excellent sense of humor. So I said to this Steve, can I ask you a question? Can I ask you a question? Yes, sir. So have you ever been to Turkish prison camp? He said, no, I tried to go into the women's camp, but I couldn't make it. I asked next day, Steve, can I ask you another question? Have you ever gone through a phase where you shaved all your hair, scalp, neck, just shiny scalp, refused to wear the Western clothes, cover your naked body with deep orange cloth from shoulders to the feet, and have the bells in your hand, and sing Hare Krishna in front of Manchester Piccadilly Station?
It's so possible.
No, he said he doesn't like freezing cold. I thought I was coming to the end.
I'll do it. Whatever the money is, I'll do it.
I'm coming to the end. I'm coming to the end. In this hall, I'm the oldest person. I'm the oldest person. And if the oldest person can't give you advice, who can? So I have to give a few advices. But the thing, the girl was...
Elizabeth?
Not Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
Olivia. Olivia. Did she read something?
Oh, Michelle.
No, Michelle.
No.
Amy.
Of Gabrielle's was so touching to me. All the advices what she has given, I think she has stolen all my words. I can't say anything better than that. What I can say that the marriage, a good marriage, what do you call this? How well suited to each other. How you can solve your differences. That is good marriage. And love, of course, love. It's an Indian proverb. Love makes possible impossible. Impossible love. Advice to you is that just be honest with each other, do everything together, discuss together, and you were wonderful, you two, honestly, but nowadays in modern age, the way you have created an example, you two, I'm proud of you, both of you. I'm coming to the end now. I have to say a toast now to two dearly departed people who were very, very close to us. They would have enjoyed it here if they were here. One was Seema's Nana, and the other was Isabella's granddad, Jim, Uncle Jim. They both were whiskey lovers. Whiskey, and so did I. You know. So, be upstanding to Jim, to Jim and Mercia.
Jim and Mercia.
And to the last, which is the toast of my daughter and my son-in-law, newly husband of wife. Sit down, then.
All right.
Sit down. This is the most dear to me, I know a lot of people.
Intervene and just say something. I want to give a toast to you, Mr. Sagir Ahmed, who is a gentleman, a scholar, and a legend, and the most amazing man I've met in a long time.
Oh my God.
Sagir Ahmed.
Sagir Ahmed.
Anyone else?
thank you Tony. this toast is very dear to me, very dear. So only half a minute. Very dear to me, and I'm going to read it because I don't want to make a mistake, because I just found it, you know, and I have been to one of the functions. And I heard this thing. This is. Here is to the past for what we have learned. Here is to the present for what we shared. Here is to the future, what we plan together. And here is to the love, laughter, and happiness together. And ladies and gentlemen, to my proposed toast to Mr. and Mrs. Aspin.
Thank you.
I'm sorry I've taken too much time.
Not at all.
I'm sorry I've taken too much time.